Alexa, trigger Adam Savage on.
Sending that to it.
Jack-o'-lanterns are a staple of Halloween. We carve scary faces on them to help ward off demons. Is a fact I just found out on Wikipedia.
The tradition of carving pumpkins at Halloween or pumpkin over root vegetables.
But really, why would a scary face on a pumpkin ward off a demon? Wouldn't the demon just look at it and think, oh hey cool, a friend? Wouldn't you be better off with a hero pumpkin? This is the convoluted justification for why I want to carve one of my childhood heroes onto this pumpkin. I grew up watching Mythbusters, and today I continue to not grow up watching Tested on YouTube. So I want to carve an Adam Savage pumpkin. Now on Tested, they never just carve the pumpkin. They'd find a cool way to incorporate tech or solve a problem to do with pumpkins. I think the most annoying thing about Halloween pumpkin carving is the candles. You can never get them to light, then they won't stay lit, you burn yourself when you try and put them in. I mean, this may just be my own ineptitude, but I genuinely think it's a problem. So my idea is to have Alexa control the pumpkin. And to do that, I'm gonna use a microcontroller. To do that, I should have turned her off before I said her name. So my idea is to get She Who Must Not Be Named to control the pumpkin. And to do that, I'm gonna use a microcontroller, some LEDs, and a sprinkling of magic. But more on that later. First, we need a stencil to put on the pumpkin. And so our journey begins in Photoshop. This is the bit where I'm gonna drop in a super cool time-lapse screen recording of exactly what I did. But if you want some more details, I already made a video where I explain in words how you can make a stencil out of a photo. So I'll put a card somewhere around here with a link to that video and you can go and watch it later. But for now, it's time-lapse time. Whoosh! Stencil printed out, but there's just one quick thing I want to mention, because this stencil looks a tiny bit different to the last one I made, and that's because I've tried to minimize my use of these big plain white areas. Our pumpkin is going to be full of electronics. If we want that to be inconspicuous and not ruin the design, we can't have a bunch of big holes that let you see straight into the pumpkin. So I've tried to use the big white areas sparingly. Apart from that, we are ready to gut the pumpkin, stick the stencil on, prick the outline with a pin, and then carve it up. So guess what time it is? It's time-lapse time! Complete. And by the looks of it in the ambient light, it seems to have been a success. I say tentatively. Before I get started on the electronics, I still want to test it the good old-fashioned analog way with some candles. Whoever you are, you're home just in time for the big reveal. Hi.
Hi.
Now that I know that the carving wasn't an abject failure, we can get on with the electronics. Now the lighting is the easy part. Few LEDs should have roughly the same brightness as the kind of candle you'd stick in a pumpkin. If I was more organised, I might have bought the cute flickery ones that look like real candles, but I'm not, and I didn't, so deal with it. Next, we're going to need a way to control our LEDs turning on and off. That's where our microcontroller comes in. It's going to be the brains of our pumpkin. It's very Halloween with putting brains in pumpkins. But how is it going to know when we want the LEDs to switch off and on? We have our microcontroller and we have Alexa, and we want them to talk to each other. Alexa is connected to the internet. And the
sorry, I don't know that.
You should know that you're connected to the internet. Alexa, are you connected to the internet?
I am connected to the internet.
See? She knows. She's gonna go to bed for a while. So I've got my microcontroller and I've got she who must not be named, and I want them to talk to each other. She who must not be named is connected to the internet. The board that I've chosen to use, Adafruit Feather M0 Wi-Fi, can also be connected to the internet, so that might be a good place for them to chat. There's a lot of different ways of getting them to communicate, but I'm lazy, so I've picked a couple of services that will translate the instructions I give to her and make them easy to interpret for my microcontroller, and also mean that I don't have to write much code, which leaves me more time to do stuff. Cut all the toenails on my 12 feet. Carve more pumpkins, I guess. I'll be using a service called If This Then That. You connect If This Then That to other accounts and services that you use, and then create applets that have a trigger and an action. When If This Then That notices that the trigger has happened, it causes the action. So, for example, you could have it automatically save your Instagram photos to Google Drive to back them up. I'm going to use Alexa as a trigger. So when I say a specific phrase to Alexa, If This Then That is going to cause an action to happen. And the action that I'm going to use is Adafruit.io. Adafruit.io is a website where you can make an account and have a bunch of data streams that are easy to read and update from internet-connected devices. So when I say a phrase like, Alexa, turn the pumpkin on or off, If This Then That is going to trigger the action of saving either a 0 or a 1 to my data feed. My microcontroller is going to be watching that data feed, and when it receives a 0, it'll turn the pumpkin off, and when it receives a 1, it'll turn the pumpkin on. Time to write some code. Oh, I just closed it. Oh, did I just try and compile the nonsense I just typed? Yeah, I did. These are not my glasses, I cannot see. That will do. And so it is time to put the electronics in here and hope that the pumpkin gunk doesn't short anything out. I have an ingenious solution to this problem. which may or may not be a paper plate covered in cling film, but it's gonna have to do. Moment of truth. Moment of truth. Alexa, trigger Adam Savage on.
Sending that to it.
Yay! I'm always so surprised when the things that I make work. Alexa, trigger Adam Savage off.
Sending that to it.
Alexa, trigger Adam Savage on.
Sending that to it.
Alexa, trigger Adam Savage off.
Sending that to it.
Alexa, trigger Adam Savage on.
Sending that to it.
Well, that's so simple, it almost feels like an anti-climax after all that work. Don't get me wrong, I am still gonna spend the next hour or so switching it off and on again. But if you're looking for a better way to amuse yourself, maybe you could watch another one of my videos? You could even subscribe to my channel, I make dumb stuff pretty regularly, and you don't wanna miss that. Anyway, let me know in the comments who would be your hero pumpkin, and hopefully see you soon. Alexa, say bye to everyone.
Sorry, I'm not sure about that.
God. Alexa, you've let me down.
Just to confirm, you'd like to hear the song Let Me Down Slowly.
No! Alexa, trigger Adam Savage on.
Sending that to it.
Alexa, trigger Adam Savage off.
Sending that to it.
That was trashed. How do you get distracted by your own knees? If you're crappy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're crappy and you know it, clap your hands. Alexa, give me a pumpkin fact.
Here's a fact about pumpkins. According to Wikipedia, when ripe, the pumpkin can be boiled, steamed, or roasted.
Alexa, give me another pumpkin fact.
Here's a fact about pumpkins. According to Wikipedia, when ripe, the pumpkin can be boiled, steamed, or roasted.
That's the same fact! I've got my pretzel. I think I just said pretzel. Don't film videos when you're hungry. Do the cushions look bad? They're fine. I don't know what I'm doing. Oh yeah, that's just like I normally write code. I've just saved this as DTGPRU. This is so stuck.
It will never come on.
It might never. That's okay. We can always do electronics on the coffee table now. Let's turn it all off before it explodes.